RKidz News, Lillian Freckleface.
And I'm Peach Day.
It's on!
Double bow, double jump, oh my god.
Hello and welcome to RKidz News. I'm Lillian Frecklefuzz.
And I'm Peach Stank, and here are today's top stories. The company SpaceX launched its first rocket, tastefully named Milky Way, into the atmosphere this afternoon. Aboard the ship was legendary astronaut Steve Holliday and his pet monkey, Comet. Before the launch, we asked Steve what his favorite key on the keyboard was. And in true astronaut fashion, Steve replied, "The space bar." Oh, Steve.
I would say that that reply was out of this world.
Oh, Lillian. Yes, indeed. And now Steve and his monkey are too.
Oh, you are a riot, Pete. Stop. In other news, we hope that you're ready for some family fun this Saturday as Zoo Boise opens its doors for Family Day. This event will include face painting, balloon animals, as well as a special lunch for all the animals of the zoo to enjoy. We asked Bernita Reed, the zoo polar bear expert, what the polar bears will be eating for that special lunch, and she replied, ice burgers. Burgers.
Oh.
You get it? Burger.
That's delicious. Now, let's check in with our weather correspondent, Kelly Bueno, to see what the weather looks like today.
Whoa, it's hot!
Thank you, Kelly. Lillian, I think it's time to hit the beach.
Ooh, I'm ready to bust out my boogie board.
Oh, boogie on down with your bad self.
Boogie. And now I think it's time that we see this week's COVID sports clip of the week. Well, that looks like a smashing good time.
Stop.
I know. Well, they sure knew how to make some lemonade out of those lemons. Mm-hmm. Oh, ooh. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Roxanne has just handed me a reported. It appears that we have some breaking news. Hmm. And it says there are reports of a man named Saul stumbling around the city of Damascus with something like scales over his eyes.
Hmm. Well, that sounds a little fishy to me.
You stop it. Hook, line, and sinker on that one.
Oh, stop.
According to our report, this happened after the Lord appeared as a bright light to Saul, who was on his way to arrest followers of Jesus. And this is all the information I have on this report.
Well, it sounds like he will need a little bit of faith to make it through.
It sure does, Peter. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, that faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see.
And we will see how this story unfolds. But first, back to our regularly scheduled program.
We'll see you next time. And remember, our kids, stay focused.
Life, only you can, only you can. calling out your name.
When the weight on life begins to fall, on the name of Jesus I will call. For I know my God is in control, and His purpose is unshakable. Doesn't matter what I feel, doesn't matter what. Now I'm casting out all fear, for your love has set me free. My hope will always be in your promises to me. Yeah. Oh. As I walk into the days to come, I will not forget what you have done. For you have supplied my every need, oh, and your presence is enough for me. Yes. Doesn't matter what I feel, doesn't matter what I see, my hope will always be your promises to me. I'm casting out all fear, for your love has set me free. My hope will always be in your promises to me. doesn't matter what I feel, doesn't matter what I see, my hope will always be in your promises to me. Now I'm casting out all fear, for your love has set me free, my hope will always be in your promises to me. Doesn't matter what I feel, doesn't matter what I see, my hope will always be in your promises to me. Now I'm casting out.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, that's a perfect shot. Just hold it right there. Whatever you're giving me. That's awesome.
Mm-hmm. Can I go get ready for the show now?
No. I'm still setting up the shot. Okay. Ooh, this looks good. Yeah, that looks awesome.
I have been standing here for 30 minutes, John.
You can't rush art, Brandon.
Oh, we're making art now?
When have we ever not made art? Here we go. Oh, this is beautiful. Oh, I got an idea.
Okay.
Ready?
How much longer?
Just hold still. Not much longer. Here we go. You ready?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I'm gonna zoom in. And then you're gonna zoom out. You're gonna zoom in. And then you're gonna zoom out. And you're gonna zoom in.
Okay, I'm done. I'm done.
Okay.
That's it.
Go take a break. Just can you bring your stand in? Please?
Yeah.
Thank you. All right. That's great. All right, stay right there. That's
why?
Perfect. Not you. I'm talking to your stand in. Oh. You are allowed to leave, man. Actors. Glad we got rid of that guy, right? Oh, wait, that's perfect. Just hold it right there. Okay. And then we zoom in. Oh, yeah, look at those eyes. Then we zoom out. Then we zoom in. Yes! We zoom out. And then we do a spin. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, this is great. We go faster! 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 Oh! Cut!
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the So-and-So Show. I'm Brandon.
And I'm John Spiders.
No.
Horses.
No.
Nails on a chalkboard.
No, John. John's trying to figure out what I'm afraid of.
Nothing scares you.
I can't think of anything. Sorry.
What if your fingers suddenly turn into worms?
Can't really picture that.
Oh, here. I'll help.
No, I think I'd actually find that pretty fascinating. Anyway, have we got a great show for you today?
The power going out!
No.
Storms!
Oh no, I love thunderstorms. Can we do the show now?
Sure.
All right, so today.
What about Oreos that have earwax filling? Oh!
I find that disgusting, but it's not scary.
Oh, well, we'll see about that. Because it's time for a game I call Fear the Filling.
Fear the Filling.
Here's how this game works. Someone has replaced the normally delicious filling from these Oreo cookies with a filling that may or may not be delicious. All we have to do is taste the Oreo and guess the right flavor. First one to guess two correctly wins the game. Unless, of course, you fear the filling.
I don't think so. Let's play.
That's great. Filling number one. Ooh, he's scared.
No,
I am terrified. Ooh.
Oh, it's gross. What is that?
Oh. Ew. Sunscreen.
How do you know what sunscreen tastes like?
I don't want my tongue to get sunburned.
Okay.
All right. Next filling.
All right. Oh.
Whoa.
Ooh. Oh man, they're red. You scared?
No.
I want to run away screaming.
Okay. Oh, hot, hot. Ah.
Strawberry?
Oh!
No, no, it's some kind of hot sauce. Yeah. Okay, fine. All right.
Can I have some milk, please?
I got it right. Oh. Isn't that hot? You gonna be okay?
Next feeling.
All right.
Oh, it's green.
Yeah.
No. Nate! Don't touch that! It's green! Do you know what that could be? That could be some sort of dangerous mold or grasshopper guts or some sort of radioactive toxin. Don't touch it.
I'm not afraid.
No, don't. Yeah, you should be afraid. No! Brandon, no! No! Oh, Brandon!
Mint. Guess I win. It's Bible story time with Kellen.
Hey guys.
What's up, Kellen?
You got a story for us today?
Is this segment called Bible Discussion Time with Kellen?
No, it is not.
Then yes, I've got a story.
Oh, actually, Kellen, can I help tell the Bible story today? I have a feeling I can make it more scary. I mean, I can make it more cinematic, which would be really terrifying, gratifying to our viewing audience. You know, I'm a budding filmmaker, right?
I've heard something of the sort.
It's true. I'm trending on Twitter. Listen to what people are saying. My son John wants to be a filmmaker. Looks like he won't be moving out of my basement anytime soon. Hashtag retired mom problems. Boom.
You know what? Sure, you can help. But do you mind if I do a little setup, though?
No problem.
Okay. Sometime after Jesus died and when he came back to life, there was a guy named Saul who was going from place to place finding people who believed in Jesus and throwing them in jail. But when Saul was on his way to Damascus to arrest even more Jesus followers, he had a miraculous encounter with Jesus himself. Today's story picks up 3 days after that encounter. Saul has gone without food and drink for 3 days, and he has completely lost his sight. John, take it away.
All right. And action.
In a land called Damascus.
Stop. What's that?
A wolf.
No wolves in Damascus.
It's just setting the tone.
Sure, but there were no wolves.
Fine. No wolves in Damascus. All right. Easy fix. Action.
In a land called Damascus, there lived an ordinary guy named Ananias. Did I say ordinary? Not so fast. God might have something to say about that.
Ananias.
Yes, Lord.
Go to the house of Judas on Straight Street. Ask for a man from Tarsus named Saul.
No!
Scary, right?
It's not too bad.
All right. You asked for it.
Lord, I've heard many reports about this Saul. He's come to Damascus to arrest your people, people like me. Surely you don't want me to go to him.
Go!
I'm just going to cut in for a sec. That's true. God asked Ananias to go help out a man who should have been his enemy, so Ananias had every reason to be scared. Not sure if God's voice sounded like that, but I don't know for sure, so I'm going to let that one slide. In any case, Ananias did what God told him to. John?
Yep.
When God tells you to go, you go.
Thank you. What's with the fish?
Because of the scales.
The scales. Oh, okay, fine. Carry on.
Would Ananias let fear stop him from doing what God wanted him to do?
Brother Saul, the Lord has sent me to you so you will be able to see. You will be filled with the Holy Spirit. Something like scales has fallen from your eyes!
That's really great. Though, just in case you were wondering, Saul probably didn't have fish on his face.
Just trying to be biblically accurate, Kellen.
Yeah, so Ananias helped Saul see again. And I'm telling you, Saul was a completely different human being after that. He got up, he got baptized, and after he got his strength back, he started telling everyone he could that Jesus was the Son of God. Which goes to show you, when you go and—
Wait, Kellen, the story isn't over yet.
You have more.
Oh, yeah. This is the really scary, I mean, really emotionally moving part coming up.
Oh, boy.
Saul used to terrify followers of Jesus. Now, it was his turn to be terrified.
Saul, you're in danger. Some bad people are going to try and kill you. You have to leave the city! No!
Mystery, intrigue, a midnight rescue through a hole in the city wall. Would Saul be safe at last? No.
Come on!
Shipwrecks, prison, unimaginable persecution.
What are you, a mannequin?
This man would face trials of these kinds and more for the rest of his life. Saul, who is also called Paul, coming soon. Or is it?
Now you're scared, aren't you?
Yeah, a little.
Ha!
If I follow Jesus, does that mean I'm gonna face trials like Saul for the rest of my life?
Ha!
I mean, I'm not gonna lie to you. Bad stuff is going to happen, and there's gonna be plenty of stuff for us to be afraid of. But here's the good news. When you follow Jesus, you've got someone who's gonna be there to help you face those fears. So sure, Saul went through some stuff, and we're gonna go through some stuff too. But it's not like you have to go through it alone. God will be with us.
I feel better already.
Great.
Thanks for your help today, John.
Yeah, you're welcome. Hey, let's do it again next week.
I mean, that would be terrifying. I mean, I can't think of another word. Bye.
Later, Kellen. Man, I thought my version of the Bible would totally scare you.
Sorry, I wish I could help you. I just don't know what I'm afraid of.
Oh. Well, hey, in that case, reveal the question! Oh, what are you afraid of?
Are you afraid of making new friends?
Yeah, or are you afraid of missing the bus and having to walk to school and then you can't decide if you should cut through old Farmer Ben's cornfield because that would be faster if his dog Dragon is asleep, or if you should take the long walk along the road even though you'll definitely be late and you're paralyzed with indecision and you end up missing the entire day of school, but you don't realize you've missed the entire day of school until the bus comes back to the very same spot that afternoon to let your friends out from school?
Or maybe you're afraid of snakes.
Yeah, talk about it with each other. What are you afraid of?
And we'll see you next time on...
The So-and-So Show! I'm always afraid I'll never get to say that at the end.
Bye!
So-and-So Show!
What? You get to say it a lot. Eat it!
So, did anyone else think it was pretty spooky when Saw had those fish taped to his eyes in today's So-and-So Show? Well, I am so thankful that Saul changed his ways and started telling other people about Jesus, even when he knew that religious leaders would come after him. He had faith through a scary situation. In fact, a lot of people in today's story had the same exact situation. We had Ananias, who had heard all these stories about Saul and how he would arrest Christians, but he still chose to have faith and help him. People like Barnabas and others who spoke up for Saul, even though they knew about his reputation. All of these people had faith and had to be courageous. And that takes us to our bottom line for today, which is knowing Jesus can help you face your fears. And we're all going to have scary situations in our life. Maybe you're new to town and you're going to a brand new school where you don't know any kids. Or maybe you have to do something that you have never done before and you're scared about what will happen. Well, what is so amazing about our God is that He provided us with the Bible, and it has all these true stories of people who had to face scary situations, but they put their faith in things they couldn't see because of what they could see. And that's exactly what our Bible verse is this month. It's Hebrews 11:1. Now, we've said it up for a couple weeks. How about you do it with me? Let's say it together. Ready? Faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. You and I can have the same faith that Saul showed in today's story. And when we have a relationship with Jesus, guess what? We have the Holy Spirit that can help us face any fears that might pop up in our life. And even though we can't see God, we can trust Him and know that He will be with us no matter what. And we can face any scary situation, like maybe Saul with the scary fish eyes in today's story. All right, well, that's all that I have for you guys today. We'll see you next time.